Hey folks, this is the LEGO City Jungle Cargo Helicopter set. It features one of the smallest interpretations that I've ever seen officially from LEGO of the sky crane style of helicopter that's designed just for lifting things. In spite of that small size though, I think it actually looks very nice. I like the shaping of it. It has a real nice flow. I also like the color scheme, including the use of the dark gray on the base of the main fuselage. And though this uses that same canopy piece that I always make fun of, that same helicopter canopy piece that they've put on so many helicopters of all different sizes, this one has a little bit of an angle to it. It's not as vertical as it usually is, I think. Maybe not. Maybe it's just the shape of the base of the cockpit there. There's something about it that really works for me. And there's just this nice flow from the base all the way up to the top of the thing. I like that curve on the side. This little bit of curve up at the top even helps with it. Just makes for something that's pleasing to the eye, to me personally. The cockpit section itself is very simple. You know, obviously you open this up and there's just a single seat there and a single control stick, but I think that's fine for the size of this thing. It seems well proportioned. They got a couple lights on this. Only thing I don't like here is how small the main rotor assembly is. You know, these blades are just short. I think they could have been extended out a little bit, would have looked better. But they've got nice struts for the main landing gear there, and they've done something a little bit different for the tail rotor. You could swap that around to the other side if you want. And it has a winch that's actually built into the thing, so that's able to work. It's fully built in. It's all the way down in the middle, but allows you to lift and lower things. You know, it is a cargo helicopter, so of course they include some cargo. This is just a crate, and you can put something in there if you want. Just has a regular plate as the top piece. You can open that up, but you know, you can use that to pick this thing up. I'm not sure if it's going to actually work right now because it's a little tough to do it without actually touching the end of the hook. Let me see if I can do it. Can I do it? No, I can't. So I'll just give it a little help here with an extra hand. There we go. And yeah, you know, you just wind the thing back on up and you can get it in nice and close. You can also use that little hoop piece with this quad ATV. You can just stick it right there in the seating position and then use this helicopter to lift that. Let's see how that works. It does appear to have enough space to fit under there, and it's pretty well balanced actually. It indeed is. I can lift that up and get it, you know, pretty nicely secured under there. Let me see if it'll actually fit one of these ways to get it a little bit more just steady and sturdy so that it won't spin around quite so much. Yeah, there we go, right there. That's a perfect spot. So now it, you know, it can swing a little bit, but it mostly just stays facing forward, which is what I wanted. I just wanted it to not be swinging all around. You can't get it all the way under there so that you can land with this, but that's not how these helicopters work. They're always going to drop off their cargo before the helicopter itself lands. So this actually is everything that I could ask for from this thing. And I'll just pull the hoop up and there we go. Wind this back up and then you take off and you have left your ATV behind. Now LEGO has done so many quads that I never expect to see anything new, but the designers always try. It's difficult, but they try to do something a little bit different from what they've done before with the look. So this one has a slightly different pattern for the headlights. Kind of looks like it has a little bit of a bar going across there. Kind of two, like you can just see some detail in here, even though it's just a lack of pieces with those hollow studs that are normally covered up with a grill or something. It's just a little bit different face than they usually have. And then on the back it has a rack. That's that relatively recent piece that they introduced, I think just last year. And it has a spot to hold on to a minifig accessory or two, and that's actually a new accessory. It's a machete, or if you're American, just say machete. It's a new mold. I think it looks pretty cool. It has a straight handle on it, so you can fit it anywhere in a hand or a clip. And it has a nice shape. Here's how that looks in the hand of a minifigure, and that makes this a perfect time to look at the two minifigures included in the set. I like the use of the dark orange color, which is fairly uncommon, and they've used a print of the orangish yellow or yellowish orange color on there, which ends up looking kind of earth orange when it's printed against the dark orange background. But you know what I like about these prints the most for the Jungle Exploration series for this year? It's the fact that they have no logos on them. I mean, they have really good detail, really, really good detail, especially for something that's not a licensed IP, but they have no logos on them so that, you know, once the Jungle Exploration theme is long gone and forgotten about, you can continue to use these prints without having a stamp on them that says, these were specifically used with this specific theme in this specific year. Like a lot of the previous dinosaur related ones and mining related ones and such, you know, that always have a little logo that's printed onto them, which looks cool and all, but becomes dated very quickly and kind of restricts the use. Like if I wanted to use this for a mining company, I could, you know, they're going and they're exploring and doing some prospecting for gold in a mountain range or for rubies or something. And it works perfectly fine. There's nothing on here that says these folks are specifically looking in a South American jungle. And that's great. The more generic, the better. And then there's just this small terrain build, which includes a little bit of some old temple ruins or something, and you know, a little bit of foliage growing around it. And they've got this palm leaf here, or palmetto leaf, which you can just move to the side to unveil a little bit of treasure, which you can then put into this bin, put the top on it, and then haul it away very carefully on your cargo helicopter. This is just a nice small build. You know, it is just a small thing. It uses a minimum number of pieces for its size, but I really think it looks good, and it stands on its own just fine. Plus, it will integrate in very well with other things, other builds, small or large, from this theme. Also, I'll go ahead and take this opportunity to take a better look at the new spider mold. When you take a look at that, that's different. It's way more realistic and believable than the old one was. I don't particularly feel they needed to make a new one. I think the old one was perfectly fine in its own right, and it also had the clip on the front that allowed you to attach something into the pincers there. But it's different. It's definitely more creepy, and when you get this in different colors, if they make one in a dark brown or they make one in a black, I think it's going to look even more interesting, and we'll just invite folks to put a little bit of color on the eyes to make those stand out. Even this one right now, just use a small little Sharpie and darken up those eyes, it'll look even more believable. But I think it's cool. I think it looks cool, but I will miss the old one. I'm assuming that they've discontinued the old one, won't continue to use it much in the future. This should just replace it. But I will miss the ability to attach something to the mouth, even though it probably wasn't done all that frequently. Altogether, I think this is actually a really nice set. Yes, it's just another small Lego City helicopter that uses that same canopy piece as always, but they actually make it look nice. Yes, it's just another Lego City cargo helicopter that's just a crane, but they usually make those too large and too expensive for what they can do. This is nice and compact, and the price to part ratio is great. Yes, there's just another generic Lego City quad ATV, but it actually looks pretty nice and has a little bit of utility, and they try to do some things that are different. Yes, there is just another generic random terrain piece that's included, but I think it actually does look nice with other stuff or without. And you know, you get a couple of new molds with this theme in general that are represented here. There's just nothing here that I dislike. There's nothing here that I feel that they've truly done poorly that really needs improvement. Yeah, could have used longer rotors, but that's really no big deal. I think this is good. I think this is exactly what LEGO needs to do in the City line. Let me know if you agree or if you disagree. I look forward to your thoughts, and I'll be reviewing the rest of this series, so stay tuned for that. I'll talk to you again soon.